Well, hello, and welcome back to another episode of Jack Wall Drives Euro Truck Simulator 2. This is a Let's Play. We're going to jump straight into the jobs market and see what truck we want to drive next. So, the last truck we drove was a Volvo, the first truck being the Mercedes. We are kind of going for the money. And this is a Globetrotter XL, which is different to the previous truck. It's another Volvo. There's an Iveco Drawless Active Super here. Now, I did say I was going for the money, but I also need to experience the different trucks that are going on, so I'm going to pick the Iveco in this case, and we're going to take it from Vienna to Salzburg. It still pays a decent amount of money. The difference is 60 whatever euros, so I think we'll take that as no difference. Okay, we'll take that and load up and see how we do. So this is an Iveco Stralis Active Super. Let's see. I have a new mail. I'm not really interested in looking at the mail. Okay, well, we're all loaded up. Well, this is nice enough. Nothing wrong inside here. Got the radios up there. The mirrors are switched around with the wide view mirror above the long one. I don't know what the names of these mirrors are. The big one and the small one on the left and the right. It has a mirror that looks over the front as well. So there's no GPS yet in any of these trucks. Dashboard is looking a little different, but has most of the same information on there. Temperature is already 92 degrees. Yeah, that's so let's just fit it in. Okay, that's not very intelligent. Okay. Okay, lights are on. Find the gear and away we go. Wow, this sounds different again. And yet it's not bad. It's quite nice. Indicators. Nice and steady. There's a human, human form of an AI walking on the street. A little bit late of a reaction there, but she was blonde. Okie dokie, where are you going, mate? You're off. Right. I'll drop the bad accents because they're terrible. Right, it's a bit jumpy here, but we're getting there. Okay, well, this truck doesn't seem to have the same oomph of the Volvo. But I know nothing about it. We haven't really looked at the details of the truck. She growls a little bit, though, but she's... I mean, we're only pulling 22 tons. Okay, it's not exactly a light load either. Okay, it's fine. It's fine. It's an Iveco. Iveco. I say Iveco, you say Iveco. Whatever the rest of you say. God, that indicator would drive me mad. Such a little thing, but it's just like, I'm not really interested in indicating. Right. I'm actually using a G25, but it might appear that I'm driving... Oh, okay, this is not working at all. I'm really not comfortable with the steering now. The dead zone is actually a bad idea because I don't have any... I've got to pass through that dead zone and I'm really, really noticing it. God, look, yeah, I've got to... And then I overcompensate. I guess I get used to it, but I don't think I want to. So next opportunity to pull over, I'm going to fix my steering before I have another unnecessary accident. So it's 3 hours and 42 minutes this time. Ah, yeah, look at that. Alright, this is shit. This is very bad, very bad, very bad. Ah, I don't like this at all. I might actually pull over here. I can't really pull over here though. Oh, parking coming up soon. Okay. There's that stupid driver from the last episode. Oh, he's coming up on my inside. He's not going to let me in. Yeah. I got issues here, man, and you're just... what's going on? Oh, she's pulling up the hill. There you go. God, she's noisy. Alright, we're going in here to fix our steering. Hopefully there won't be too many interruptions like this in our driving, because once we get it set up properly, then it's going to be saved as such, and it'll be good. Now, I'm going to stop here because that's good. Stick on my really fast blinkers, and I'm going to pop back into the options. And oh, it wasn't there; it was here. And take off that dead zone altogether because it's really, really bad. But the sensitivity I'm going to take right down as well. Non-linearity, I'm going to move that up into the middle. Let's see how that is. Forgive me, there'll be a couple of iterations probably of this till we get this right. Oh god, there's a delay there now as well. That's not very good. Okay, one more time. Sensitivity is very low. Ooh, maybe if I was to bring them both up. How does that look? Yeah, I've got a male. That's actually not too bad, but the linearity is way off. Okay, last time. I think I know what I'm doing now. Yeah. We'll have a little bit of non-linearity, but really, it's when I turn the steering, I wanted to turn with it. No. That wasn't the last time. What do we do when we have it up like that? Yeah. Okay, that's where we need to be now. Okay, this will hopefully be the last time. I'm going to bring my sensitivity back down, but I'm bringing my non-linearity up to the full. And I've still got a message. Ah, yeah, now that feels better. Mightn't look any different on the screen, but that makes more sense for me here. Okay. So, we are away again. After that little small interruption. Yeah. We're a lot more comfortable in the cab here now, ladies and gentlemen. The track IOR is really good. I quite like it. I probably have a few little improvements in setup to make with the smoothing and you know, some of the profiles for looking around the cab, but it gives you that ability to swivel your head and replicate on the screen what you're expecting to see, you know. It's not just like the function, the mouse controls or the button controls where you can just flick over and back. You know, you can gradually get over, you're expecting the mirror to come into view, there it is, have a look and you can go back. Plus I can also kind of turn my head but keep my eyes looking on the road. You know, which obviously you can't see my eyes, but it's nice. I think that I probably have to do a little bit more work to get it tuned to whatever perfection is, but it's pretty good news that SES software has ensured that it's covered within the code of the game and that it's recognized and supported, because it makes a huge difference to the immersion of the game for me. And yeah, I would recommend it as a product. I was gifted mine. I did make a free track prior to that with an old webcam that I had, and that worked quite well. It wasn't very neat and tidy though. I didn't make a very good job of a professional or semi-professional looking track free tracker, and it was I built it onto a baseball cap, as most people do, but there was wires hanging around everywhere, and yeah, it was a bit annoying sometimes because you know, you had this wire that was running down off the back of your cap and had to loop around underneath you. So that was a bit of a kind of a not so good thing. But I think things have improved and people have come up with new ideas and they've refined the free track quite a lot, so some free tracks out there are pretty neat now. But I was gifted a track IO 5 and I am very, 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 very thankful for it, because it's neat and tidy and it does what it says on the tin, and yeah, I would highly recommend it to anybody who's considering it. It's not the cheapest purchase on the shelf, but if you play a lot of driving games, or if you play a lot of games in general, because there's a huge range of games that are supported now, it does really help, and it's a bit of an investment. It's, you know, it's well over 140 euro, I think. So it's you know, it's saving pocket money for a while, I suppose, for many. But it really is something that once you have it, you'll think, okay, actually, I don't really not want to be without this now. Playing a game without it is no, it's not that fun. It spoils you really, because it gives you that freedom. You know, on the simplest level, you're not needing to map a keystroke to look around. You don't need to take your hand off the controls for just the purpose of having a look around. Your head is doing that. By turning your head left, your screen is panned left, and it's just, I can't say enough about it. So if you're considering one and you're not sure, then you won't look back. If you can make the free track model, you'll be equally as comfortable with it. It's fairly straightforward to make. You just need a little bit of time and you know, just technical skill. But it's not very high technical skill. You have to be prepared to get in and have a go, basically. If you're prepared to get in and have a go, you'll be successful with all the information that's on the forums and so on and so forth. It'll definitely enhance your gaming experience, though, so do it. Just do it. Do it. Do it. Do it. Painting mountains in front of me. Do you see it? That landscape is pretty nice, though. I don't know. My view distance might be off or whatever is going on there, because those mountains are just appearing up and down, and it's kind of weird. I shall have to look into that. But it is quite a nice view there, isn't it? Wow. And you know, the thing is, I know this part of the country, of this part of the world, and the view out the window in the cab here, I kind of have a sense that I'm in the part of the world that is being depicted in the game. Meaning the game reflects the landscape quite nicely compared to reality, and yeah, it's quite impressive. They've managed to, whatever it is, they've got the horizons right, and they've got the topology, I think is the word, isn't it, of the local area. It's believable. You could really believe that. Yeah, this is Austria. Yeah, I could go with that. So it'll be interesting to see when we get further afield, what the landscapes of different countries look like, and if they're if they're changed to reflect those national differences in landscape and sense of, you know, just the look of the place gives you the impression that this is not, you know, a hot, dry country. It's a wet, rainy, but lovely green one, you know, Wales, Ireland, Scotland, lots of England as well, northern France, plenty parts of Germany. But it doesn't have the dominating mountains that Austria would, certainly northern and western Austria would have, southern Germany has. Whoa, way too fast, way too fast, way too fast. Did manage to knock off most of the speed there, but that wasn't very polite or well executed. Okay. I do have the retarder and I'm not using it. Well, I am now, but I wasn't. Silly me. Sun's going down. What time is it? Almost 7 in the game. 7 evening time in the game. But we're a few minutes away from the delivery, and the delivery incidentally is to Eurogoodies. So I'm going to translate across into this other lane. As soon as she pulls herself up the hill, come on, tractor. Okay, so this particular Iveco Stralis Active Super, I must do something to look at the information of the trucks going forward so that you can see those. This doesn't have a very powerful engine. It's got enough, but not much more than enough. And it's got very loud brakes or air valves. Going to the left here, so I'll indicate. I don't think I'm going to make those lights, because there's 1, 2, 3. I'm number 5. No, didn't think so. But that's okay. I can just pass the time listening to this ridiculously slow indicator. I mean, come on. Whoever programmed this thing, what is that? It's a delay of a second, 1001. It's a half a second delay in that. Now, what are you going to do, car? You going to do? No, you're not. Good. All right. Enough of the lazy indicator. Well, I can't really put that on the positive side of the attributes of this truck. On the positive side, so the mirrors are pretty good again. I'm liking those. Sound is interesting. You know, Neil Peart is playing the drums in the background though, with that hitting that bass drum every so often when the valve releases, which is fairly loud. This is Eurogoodies, isn't it? Yeah, it is. Should have a little white fella. There it is. So we'll go in here and we'll try and park up. Okie dokie. Skipped parking to complete delivery. Now, I don't know how I should do this parking, but I'm going to go into the corner here and try and get the trailer angled a little bit. Yeah, that'll do. Head out the window again. Sorry about the noise. Now, slow is usually the better tactic with reversing. And there's always a tendency to kind of, oh, I'm good now, I'll speed up and get it done. But okay, I'm happy with this. There we go. We will call that delivered. the Iveco has given us a nice run. We've got a few bob, we've got a good few X points, XP, experience points, and we're now up another level, so good progress. Okay, like I talked about before, we're going to just fail in the long distance and get that established, and use that to make some dough. Got a couple of emails more. Dear sir, this is from the bank, so la la la, favorable loans, funding to get your business flying, more advertising for loans, and drivers with own equipment needed. Well, I don't have any of my own equipment, so this is not going to apply to me, but Postspeed in Linz is looking for skilled drivers with their own trucks, and they'll pay 5,600 for a job. Okay. 5,600 would be nice to earn. I'm not doing that, but I'm up to 8,400 and change. Well, that ends this episode. Go handy and catch you later.